Welcome, friends, to another installment of, you know, a U.S. Marine Reacts 2. I am your host, Alpha Kilo. And I can't, like, this video just made me laugh so hard. And if you don't know my political alignment, it's more centralist than anything, so. But I just can't get over this lady. So I'm just going to react to crazy liberal lady. And let's go.
And she joins us tonight. Kathy, it's great to see you.
Hi, good to see you.
I gotta say, there's kind of a basic irony here. I mean, you're lecturing us about sexism while you're sitting right now in Manhattan.
Manhattan. We need to rename the city then.
We need to... Oh, God, rename the city. Okay.
The Big Apple. The Big Apple would be less offensive. So I feel that I'm sitting in the Big
Tucker's
Apple,
face.
Not Manhattan.
Okay, but why stop there? Why should the post office deliver mail?
I know. Well, it's spelled M-A-I-L, so that's okay. If it's M-A-L-E, there's a problem.
Homonyms count, and this applies to email, too, because it's not about spelling. It's about being gender inclusive,
right.
And mail is
He's
offensive.
Like
we just learned
soft,
that.
Hard trolling her.
Well, no, I don't think they're including that, but they are saying that society has changed and times are changing, and we don't want to be offensive in our language. And they're trying to be non-sexist and non-biased, and that means trying to take the word man out. So instead of man-made, it would be synthetic. So instead of mailman, it would be mail carrier. So there's many ways to go around it. Instead of humanity, you should say people.
But so, mail carrier still has mail in it. So you haven't, it's kind of a fake, but that's a dodge.
Oh, package carrier. I mean, we can come up with so many terms
that's
that are less offensive. Yeah.
You might still offend dyslexics. You can change a vowel, but it sounds the same. It has that dreaded word that sends people shrieking for their safe spaces, mail.
Well, they're saying man. Man is the word that they're trying to avoid. They're saying that the word man is associated with adult men, as opposed to just humanity or humans. So they're trying to avoid the word man. So if we can eliminate that word,
Tucker was trying so hard not to laugh there.
Much better, and people would be less offended.
Well, what if you lived in Manchester, Vermont?
Well, they might have to change the name of the city if people agree with Purdue University.
We're going to change the name of a city because a very select few people are offended at just three fucking letters, M-A-N.
And Purdue University found that things need to be updated, and they updated their writing guide to take out these words that apparently are offending certain groups of people.
Okay, so just to make sure I understand the rule, if something offends somebody, even if you've never met that person personally...
Right. Right.
You have to change it. So doesn't that mean that a small group of super unhappy people get to control what the rest of us say in things?
Bruh, I like these editors. They just like fucking... Nope. Other way. They just like fucking wrecked her. If you write in a sexist manner and alienate much of your audience from your discussion, your writing will be much less effective. Dude, these editors are fucking brilliant because they just fuck... They're like, hey, well, most of the audience is probably going to be men. So,
Well, perhaps they're ahead of their time. Maybe this is something that is offending a small group, but the group's going to get larger, and times are changing, and our language is dynamic. Webster keeps adding new words in the dictionary.
Like selfie.
So our language needs to change, and a term that used to be non-offensive, like man-made and male-man, now needs to be changed.
Well, I get that. I guess the question for me is who gets to decide what changes and what doesn't? So, for example, I think I've now decided that the most offensive word in the language is college professor.
Ooh.
Okay, because to me that connotes dumbness and misuse of power and tenure,
so
and mediocrity. So maybe I'd like to say no one can use that word ever again in my presence because it offends me. Would that fly? Could I do that? Could I pull that off?
Well, if you have a writing guide, perhaps, and you put that out there and people agree with you, then maybe that would fly.
I agree
but
with
Purdue
them.
University did find a group that agreed with them, and the university backed them up, and there you have it. They have a writing guide that now is going to teach us how to not offend.
But do you think they have the guts? I mean, it's one thing to bully the little rich kids who go to your school, because, like, what do they know? But do you think they have the guts?
This is the heart of America.
Yeah, no, of course. But I mean, if you're paying, like, 60 grand or whatever it is for, like, the fake diploma you get, you know, you're not working. Obviously, you're privileged by definition.
Throw on fire.
But, but it's easy to boss them around. Do you think they would have the guts to go to Goldman Sachs in New York and say, change your name now or else?
They probably wouldn't shop there. They probably wouldn't shop there because
what if they were shopping at Goldman Sachs? They might come up short because it's a bank.
Because the name man is adult male, and yeah, we need to change it. Like woman, I mean, has the word man in there, so just call us a person.
So old person sacks.
That was such a condescending.
That be better?
I think so. I'm less offended. Yeah.
And by the way, what if you just, since the rule is if you spell, and I'll stop with this because I know this is angel in the head of a pin at this point, but if you spelled man differently, like M-A-A, so it was male man, but M-A-A-N.
No, the profession, we know that the professions usually were male dominated and they've changed.
What?
So no, saying male man.
I have known so many more female mailmen than any like other profession. I've seen so many female, you know, male dominated. Show your fucking work.
Man and spelling it differently, that doesn't apply. We're trying to say this profession now applies for men and women or persons.
It's been like this since what, like 1967? Equal Rights Act. Moving on.
All people. No.
Wait,
man
isn't
needed.
There a man?
No
man hold on. Needed. Isn't there a man in the word woman?
Call me a person. I'd be less offended. No need for woman.
Okay.
Yeah.
In the end, the revolution always eats itself, as we often point out. Kathy, thank you for that guided tour of the Lunar regions. Appreciate it.
No problem.
Oh yeah, I couldn't find it on like the Tucker Carlson like Fox News official page. So, Liberty Hound, thank you for letting me use this video. Oh god, that was funnier than shit. So in closing, oops. God, I have all the pop-ups apparently. In closing, the left is still deranged. The right still makes fun of the left. Not much has changed, so. Some people, they just need an angry person yelling in their face and they'll figure out what's wrong with themselves. All right. If you like the content, like, comment, subscribe. Leave a negative comment if you didn't, because I don't give a shit. You still watch my videos. Thanks again to Liberty Hound for letting me use their videos. And yeah. See you guys later.